So now, friends, let us see the new chapter on gradient, divergence, and curl. So these three are the basic points of the new chapter. This chapter is very very simple chapter. Each of the three concepts are very easy to understand, and the examples based on these three concepts are very easy to solve. Because nothing is difficult, nothing is hesitating, everything you will find in a lucid way. Okay? So here we will start with the definition of a gradient. Okay, then we will go for divergence and curl. One by one we will see all the examples. Here we have to remember simple facts. Okay, so before defining gradient, in each of the three definitions we will require one special symbol. This is the symbol, and this we will call as del or nebula. Okay, but normally we will use to call this by del only. Okay, so here del is defined as I into del by del x plus j into del by del y plus k into del by del z. Okay, so this is known as a vector differential operator. Differential operator. So in objective, if you are asked what is a vector differential operator, then you don't have to worry. Simply del, that means del is known as the vector differential operator, and it is defined as I del by del x plus j del by del y plus k del by del z, where del by del x is the differential operator with respect to x. It is the differential operator with respect to y. It is the differential operator with respect to z. So it is known as differential because there it is only obtained, and these are operators, so differential operators, and it is written into the vector style form I, j and k. Okay? I, j and k. It is an operator because here no function is written. No function is written. So without function, you know, in ordinary derivative also, d by dx is simply an operator without function. But when we write y, then it will become function. Then it will become a function. So this is the vector differential operator. Or simply, we can also write this is into the single form I del by del x, sigma. Okay? If we don't want to write this into elaborative form, then we can write down this is sigma I del by del x, where sigma runs over x, y, z or I, j, k. That means first we write down I del by del x. Normally you might have studied sigma as from I equal 1 to n. That means from 1, then 2, then 3 and so on. But here instead of sigma runs from x, y and z. X, comma, y, comma, z or I, j and k. I, j and k. If you write, you want to write. If you don't write this, then it will do. Okay? That means first you write down I del by del x, then plus, because of sigma it will become plus. Instead of replace I and x, j and y, then plus, replace I and x by k and z, you will get the whole expression. Okay? Because sometimes if you are not required to find out each derivatives separately, then you can express this into the form of one derivative. That means when the function here is in symmetric form is more. Suppose I will write down x, r square equal x1 plus y square plus z square. This is known as symmetric form. Symmetric means what? If you interchange the roles of x, y, and z, that means if you interchange x by y by z, and z by x, it will remain same. It will remain same. That means by interchanging their roles, if you will get the same, then it is known as symmetric form. Okay? So vector differential operator we will use. So you must try to practice what is a vector differential operator. Then we will have this deal common in all the three definitions. Common in all the three definitions. In gradient, then we will operate. This is the operator. This is the operator. Like I told you that d by dx is the operator, and this operator we can operate upon some function y. Some function y. So here this operator we want to operate on the some function. But here functions are of two types. Two types. Either a scalar function or a vector function. Scalar function or a vector function. So first of all we consider a scalar function. Scalar function. And normally scalar function we denote by phi or f. Phi or f. Okay, whatever you like or whatever we will be given. Okay, so these are known as scalar functions. Scalar functions means in which there is no ijk involved. So we will operate this upon scalar function. So we will write down del f. Here I have written f from right side, not from left. So you must see this sequence. Okay. So here this will become now I del f by del x plus j del f by del y plus k del f by del z. Okay. So now this has been converted into the functional form. It is into the functional form. And this is known as the gradient of f. This is known as gradient of f. Okay. And we can also denote this as grade into bracket f. So it is denoted into two forms, grade f or del f. Del f. Okay. So this is the gradient function. You must remember it. Okay. Simultaneously, I will also define you about or else we can also write this into sigma form as I into del f by del x. Okay? Del f by del x. Then, suppose we are given a vector function. Vector function. And vector function normally we will denote by capital F bar. Capital F bar. Bar is denoted, the bar is given, so it is a vector function. And we want to operate this operator upon a vector function. See here, this is operated upon scalar function. And this is the gradient. The gradient is of a scalar function. Okay? Now we want to operate this upon a vector function. Okay? And this is a vector differential operator. This is a vector. Okay? And I told you that whenever we write the two vectors a bar and b bar simultaneously, then there must be a dot or cross in between these two. So here, so from this and this vector function, we will have two kinds of situations. That means first we will use dot and then cross. If we will use dot, then del dot f bar equal to what will happen? See, we want to operate this upon f bar by with dot product. So here I and this will become del f bar by del x because we are operating this upon function. So here f bar will become, but you can see that here again I is a vector, this is a vector f bar. Due to f bar it is a vector. So we will have to write down here dot plus j dot del f bar by del y plus k dot del f bar by del z. Okay. Or in simple form, sigma form, we can write this as I dot del f bar by del x. Because other two terms we can write down in the similar form as in the first term. Okay. And this is nothing but divergence of f bar. And we will denote this by div into bracket f bar. So divergence of f bar is del dot f bar. Divergence of f bar is del dot f bar. So you must remember this one. You must remember this one, gradient. Then the second fact here, when we operate del upon f bar, then we have one more situation of cross product, okay? Of cross product. And this is what, how can we write down here? Here we will have to write down cross del f bar by del x plus j cross del f bar by del y plus k cross del f bar by del z, okay? And sometimes this is also written as sigma I cross del f bar by del x, because other two terms we can write down into the similar form. And this is known as curl of f bar. Curl of f bar. Okay? So these are the three basic definitions. And these are very simple to understand. And these are very simple to remember as well. So you must note down these three definitions, then we will go further. You note down this. Now, let us see further. Here, you can see in gradient of f, f is a scalar function. F is a scalar function. But gradient of f, the value of gradient f is not a scalar, it is a vector function. It is a vector quantity. Because in its answer, I, j, k will be involved. Ijk will be involved. So f is a scalar function, but gradient of f is a vector function. Here, in divergence of f bar, f bar is a vector function. But here we are using dot. And you know that dot product is also known as a scalar product. Why scalar product? Because its value we can get in terms of a scalar. The value of dot product we can get in terms of scalar, because a bar dot b bar is a scalar value, you know very well. So here f bar is a vector function, but divergence of f bar is a scalar quantity. Okay, it is a scalar function. Then curl del cross f bar. Here f bar is a vector function, but we know that cross product itself is a vector. Cross product of two vectors is again a vector. So this is also a vector. So you must remember this fact, because it can be asked in the MCQ form. Okay? Now, we will completely focus on gradient of f bar, gradient of f. So, and then we will see some of the examples based on gradient f. After that, we will move towards divergence and curl. Okay, basic facts you must understand. And if you have understood these three facts, whatever the three definitions I have explained, then every example will become very simple to you. Nothing more is new, nothing more is difficult. So, now see. Gradient of f is also sometimes known as a normal to the surface. Normal to the surface f of x, y, z equal to c. Gradient f is. So sometimes if you are asked the example to find out normal vector to the surface f, to the surface f. So normal vector, if you are asked to find out to the surface s, f, then you will have to find out simply its gradient. And this is the answer. Normal to the surface means what? If you are standing over here on the surface, on the surface, then there will be some tangent vector here, and the vector perpendicular to tangent at that point is known as a normal vector. Okay? So sometimes if we are not able to find out the tangent directly, then by using the gradient we can also determine the slope of the curve. Okay? In three-dimensional space it is very much useful, gradient. Then gradient f also gives maximum rate of change in some functional value, and the modulus of gradient f is nothing but the absolute value, maximum value of the rate of change. Then one more thing is being asked, directional derivative. So you must remember these facts. So if these facts have been remembered by you, then everything will become simple. So directional derivative means what? Directional derivative. Okay? Directional derivative means that the derivative in some particular direction. Suppose here, once again I am saying that if you are standing over this hill, at some hill point, and at this point there are infinite number of directions to move. If you are standing here on some hill, then you can move in this direction, or you can move in this direction, or you can move in this direction, in this direction, in this direction, in this direction. Then there are lots of directions. So in that these directions we can find out the derivatives. We can find out the derivatives of the function. So this directional derivative we can find out. So derivative, we want to find out the derivative in some particular direction. Suppose we want to find out the particular derivative in the direction of the vector a bar, because whenever we are talking about direction, then we must think about some vector. Okay? So suppose we want to find out the derivative in the direction of this vector a bar. Okay? Then in this vector, in this direction of the vector a bar, find out unit vector. Then the directional derivative. And suppose the equation of this surface is say f of x, y, z. This surface is say f of x, y, z. So what will we do? Find out gradient of this one. Gradient of f. And take its dot product with a cap. Take its dot product with a cap. You will get the directional derivative in the direction of a bar. In the directional of a bar. But here a cap, that is unit vector, is must. Suppose we know that del f is what? I del f by del x plus j del f by del y plus k del f by del z. We know. Suppose I want to find out directional derivative in the direction of x-axis. In the direction of x-axis. And we know that in the direction of positive x-axis, the unit vector is I. The unit vector is I. So if we take dot product with I, then what will we get? Here we take its dot product with I, then I dot I is 1. So we get del f by del x. I dot j is 0 and I dot k is 0. So we can say that the directional derivative in the direction of x axis is del f by del x. Similarly, we can find out directional derivative in the direction of positive y axis is del f by del y. And the directional derivative in the direction of positive direction of positive z axis is del f by del z. So other than x, y, and z axis, also we can find out directional derivative by knowing the vector in that direction. Okay, so you must remember this del f dot a cap, because maximum the examples based on directional derivatives are being asked in the examinations. Okay. Now, let us see further. The same directional derivatives we can also find if we are given unit vector and the function f. Unit vector and the function f, whereas unit vector makes an angle. Suppose first of all we talk about two dimension only. Suppose this is the unit vector a cap. Okay, it makes an angle with positive x axis say alpha, and suppose with positive y axis say beta. Okay, then actually a cap is written as cos alpha I plus sin alpha j. You must be remembering a cap is written as cos alpha I plus sin alpha j, because a cap is magnitude 1, so its magnitude is also square root of cos square plus sin square, it is 1. Okay, or else we can also write the same thing as in terms of I alpha and beta. This is written as cos alpha plus cos beta j. But mostly in two dimensional space, if alpha is known, then we will use cos alpha I plus sin alpha j. Barabar? Okay, then we will have the directional derivative will be wrote into this form d of alpha f of x, y, z, that is directional derivative of f of x, y, z. Okay, so this is written as cos alpha f of x plus sin alpha into f of y, where f of x is what? Del f by del x, and f of y is what? Del f by del y, obviously, because gradient of f is what? I del f by del x plus j del f by del y. So if we take dot product with this one, then I dot I is 1, so del f by del x into cos alpha plus del f by del y into cos beta. Okay, so instead of cos beta you can also write down sin alpha, because alpha equal to pi by 2 minus beta, pi by 2 minus beta. So sin pi by 2 minus beta is cos beta. Okay. Suppose we consider a 3 dimensional space. Then here we know this is x, this is y, and this is z. And suppose we are given the vector say a cap. And suppose this makes an angle alpha with x axis, with y axis it makes an angle beta, and with z axis it makes an angle gamma, alpha, beta and gamma. Then in 3 dimensional space it is given as d of alpha f of x, y, z. Directional derivative is denoted by with angle alpha. Okay, alpha, actually alpha, beta, gamma are the 3 angles. So this we can write as cos alpha fx plus cos beta f of y plus cos gamma f of z. Here also we can write down cos beta. So, but it is a two dimensional space. So, cos beta equal to sin alpha, or sin alpha equal to cos beta. But here it is difficult to obtain cos beta, cos gamma in terms of alpha. So, we will write down cos alpha fx plus cos beta y f of y plus cos gamma f of z. So, directional derivative we can obtain into this way. Okay. So, suppose let us see example. Let us see one example. Find out d of alpha x0, y0 when alpha equal to 0 degree, 30 degree for the function f of x, y equal to x square minus y square, x0 equal to 1 and y0 equal to 2. So whenever you are asked to find out directional derivative, the very simple thing and common thing is that you will have to find out here we have f of x, y equal to x square minus y square. So to find out its derivatives, first of all find out its derivatives. So find out f of x, it is 2x. Then f of y, it is minus 2y. You can see it is very easy to find out. Okay, f of x is 2x and f of y is minus 2y. Then we will find out its value at the point 1, 2. At the point 1, 2, because x0, y0 is 1, 2. Their values, f of x is 1, y is 2, so 2. And f of y is minus 2, so minus 4. Okay? And here again, the first part we will solve for alpha equal to 0 degree. So alpha equal to 0 degree, so cos alpha is cos 0, 1. And sin alpha is sin 0, is 0. And therefore, d of 0 degree, f of x0, y0, the directional derivative is cos alpha fx plus sin alpha f of y. So cos alpha is 1, f of x is 2, sin alpha is 0, and f of y is minus 4. So this is 2. Okay, this is 2. The answer is 2. So the directional derivative is 2. And similarly, you can find out for the second option for alpha equal to 30 degree, and this is for your homework. You can do it. You can do it very simply. So whenever angle is given, then you can use cos alpha sin alpha or your cos alpha cos theta cos gamma. But if angle is not given and direction is given directly, then you can use grad f dot a cap. Grad f dot a cap. Here actually a cap is nothing but cos alpha I plus cos beta j plus cos gamma k. So you write down this and then you will see another example. Now let us see another example. Find the directional derivative of, because in every examination, one example is there based on directional derivatives. Find the directional derivative of the function xyz minus xy minus yz minus zx plus x plus y plus z at the point p 2, 2, 1 in the direction of the line pq, where q is 2, 2, 0. So see, this example is very very simple. Nothing is difficult. First of all, you read the question. During reading the question, you can find the directional derivative. What do we want to find? We want to find out the directional derivative of which function? Of this function. So first of all, we are write down given function. Here name of the function is not given, so we will give it the name here f of equal to xyz minus zx plus x plus y plus z. And at which point we want to find out? At the point P 2, 2, 1. That means actually if it is the surface and if it is the point P, then we want to find out the directional derivative at this point. That means we are studying over here. But in which direction? In the direction of P to Q. In this direction we want to find out. So I told you that whenever we want to find out in the direction of PQ, suppose it is A bar, then it is obtained very easily as gradient of F into A cap. Okay? So to find out directional derivative, first of all find out the derivatives. F of X, it is YZ minus Y, this derivative is 0, minus Z, X is the derivative 1, Y is the derivative 0. Then we find out F of Y, it is the derivative XZ, it is the derivative minus X, it is the derivative minus Z, it has 0, it has 0, it has 1. Then F of Z, F of Z is, it has the derivative XY, it has the derivative 0, it has the derivative minus Y, it has the derivative minus X, it has 0, 0 and it has 1. Okay, all the three derivatives have been obtained. And then we will find out the values at the point P 2, 2, 1. This shows that f of x equal to, actually why we write down at p, p 2, 2, 1 the values are, because no need to write down every time that f of x 2, 2, 1, f of y 2, 2, 1, every time no need to write down these things. So we are writing this one. So if we put y x equal to 2, y equal to 2, z equal to 1. So y equal to 2, z equal to 1. So 2, it is 2. Minus 2, 0, minus 1, plus 1, that means it is 0. F of y is what? X into z, 2, minus 2, 0, and this is 0, this is 0. F of z is what? X into y, it is 4, 4 minus y, 4 minus 2, 2, that means 2. And 2 minus 2, 0, and it is 1. It is 1. Okay? And then we want to find out A bar. So here, A bar equal to PQ bar. Actually, PQ bar, how can we obtain Q bar minus P bar? So Q bar minus P bar means what? We have the point 2 minus 2, 0, 2 minus 2, 0, and 0 minus 1, 1. So we can also write this as 0i plus 0j plus minus 1 into k. Okay, we can also write. So what is the unit vector we have? A cap equal to, we find out unit vector by dividing the vector itself by its magnitude. Its magnitude is what? Square root of 0 plus 0 square plus 1 square. That means 1. So it is nothing but 0i plus 0j minus k. Okay? And therefore, directional derivative is equal to gradient of f dot a cap. So gradient of f is what? Gradient of f dot a cap. Okay? So gradient of f is what? Here we have obtained the values fx, these are 0, 0, 1. Okay? So 0, 0, 1 dot, this is what? 0, 0, minus 1. So dot product is what? 0 into 0 plus 0 into 0 plus 1 into minus 1. That means minus 1 is the answer. Okay? So this is the directional derivative. So the whatever the terms in terms of IJK, we can also write them in the form of bracket x, y, z. Okay. Actually, here the same thing we can also find out in different way. Suppose we have obtained direction A bar, A cap in this way. But if we want to suppose do follow the way that the way of directional cosines, that means here directional ratios, we will obtain directional ratios. Directional ratios are nothing but Q minus P. Q minus P, that means 2 minus 2, 0, comma this 2 minus 2, 0, comma this 0 minus 1, 1. Okay? Then direction cosines we can have to obtain. Direction cosines. Direction cosines are nothing but dividing these values by their magnitude. Its magnitude is what? Square root of 0 plus 0 plus 1. So 1. So if we divide them by 1, then we will get the same thing. And direction cosines are nothing but actually cos alpha, cos beta and cos gamma. They are directional cosines. And directional cosines can be obtained by using this one. Okay? That means if we are given P of x1, y1, z1, P and the Q is as x2, y2, z2, then directional ratios can be obtained as x2 minus x1, y2 minus y1, z2 minus z1. And then directional cosines are obtained by dividing them by their magnitude, square root of, by taking square root of each of these terms. Okay? So by dividing them by magnitude, these are the directional cosines. That means it is cos alpha, it is cos beta, it is cos gamma. Okay? Then directional derivatives obtained as cos alpha into f of x plus cos beta into f of y plus cos gamma into f of z. And this is the same thing what we have obtained in the by finding a bar then a cap. Okay. So you also note down this example. But best way to find out del f dot a cap if angle is not given. Now let us see another example. Another example. Find the derivative of f of xy equal to x square sine 2y, x square into sine 2y at the point 1 comma pi by 2 at the point 1 comma pi by 2 1 comma pi by 2 in the direction of v bar equal to 3i minus 4j. So here in the example you can see that we want to find out derivative of. Here directional derivative is not written directly, but here you can see that in the direction of, that means it is nothing to find out directional derivative. So direction is also given, f is also given. So it is very simple. So given f of xy equal to x square sine 2y. So as I told you that first of all you find out its derivative with respect to x. With respect to x it is 2x into sine 2y. Then with respect to y it is x square is constant. So sine 2y is the integration 2 cos 2y. So 2x square cos 2y. Then we will find out at the point 1 comma pi by 2 their values. So x is 1, y is pi by 2. So x is 1, so f of x, this implies that f of x equal to 2 into 1 into sine pi by 2 into 2 and 2 and sine pi is 0. So it is 0. And f of y is what? It is 1, so 2 cos pi by 2. Pi 2 and 2 cos pi is minus 1, so it is minus 2. Then we are given the direction. Again we are given v bar equal to 3i minus 4j. So this implies that we will find out its unit vector. Actually, a bar in the formula we have written, but instead of a bar, sometimes in example we may be given b or whatever symbol is given. So this is nothing but 3i minus 4j divided by its magnitude. Its magnitude is what? 9 plus minus 4 square, that means 16. It is nothing but 3i minus 4j divided by height. And therefore, directional derivative equal to grad f dot v cap. Okay? Grad f dot v cap. So grad f is what? 0 I minus 2j dot, this is what? 3i minus 4j divided by I. Okay? So what will be, we have 1 upon 5 we take outside. So 0 into 3 is 0. And I dot I is 1. You don't write down I, j, because in dot product no I, j will be reflected. So minus 2 minus 4 is 8. So 8 by 5. Okay? Or else you can also write this as 0 comma minus 2 dot, this is 3 by 5 comma minus 4 by 5. Okay, you can also write the same thing in this way. So this is the answer. So you write down this and note down this. So these are the examples based on directional derivatives, and you must get practice with them. Next time we will see how to find out normal vector as we discussed initially in this lecture. Okay, normal vector, then unit normal vector, because all of this can be obtained by using gradient very easily. Unit, whenever the word unit is used, then nothing is difficult. You divide this vector by its magnitude, you will get unit normal vector. And normal vector is given by gradient f. Okay? Then we will see maximum rate of change. Then we will find out angle between two curves, angle between two surfaces. That means it is also very simple. Angle between two surfaces can be obtained by for the first surface, if f1 is first surface and f2 is second surface, then find out unit normal vector corresponding to this one, say m1 cap, and find out unit normal vector corresponding to this one. Unit vector can be obtained by using gradient. Then take the dot, we will get an angle. So thus examples, more examples we will see the next time. Okay? Till then, you can get practice of the examples whichever we have done over here. Thank you.